Good morning, everyone. In this part, we are going to discuss the second part of sentence analysis, that is, predicate. The predicate is the part of the sentence that tells us something about the subject. The predicate may be a single finite verb, or it may be a verb with an object or some more words that are needed to complete the meaning of the sentence. The predicate may consist of just one word or a group of words. When the predicate has only one word, it will always be a verb. We know that every predicate must have a finite verb. We have already said that the subject will be a noun or a pronoun. The predicate will contain a verb in addition to a possible modifier. Let us see the examples. First one, horses, gallop. Here horses is the subject, gallop, predicate. Here is only one word in the predicate. Second one, the class starts at 9. Here predicate is starts at 9. Here total three words are there in the predicate. In the predicate, the verb may be qualified by an adverb or a group of words that do the work of an adverb. This is called an adverbial qualification. We already told the predicate contains a verb. If there are more words except the verb doing the work of an adverb, we can call them adverbial qualification. For example, the children waited downstairs, which I highlighted is the adverbial qualification. Second, the children came home. Here, came home, a noun that behaves like an adverb of place. Third, we work to earn, a noun that behaves like an adverb of place. The toys in the room were in all shapes and sizes, a prepositional phrase doing the work of an adjective. Now, we are in the object of a verb. When we use a verb transitively, we need an object to make the meaning of the sentence complete. Transitive verbs need an object to complete their meaning. For an example, I threw the ball. Here I is the subject, threw, transitive verb, and the ball is the object. The object of a transitive verb may be a noun, a pronoun, an adjective that does the work of a noun, a participle that acts as a noun, an infinitive that does the work of a noun, a group of words that doing the work of a noun, or a noun clause. When an object consists of more than one word, we have the object word and its attributes, just like we have attributes for the subject word. In the last class, we have already learned subject word and its attributes. Like the same way, object also have object word and its attributes. When an object consists of more than one word, we have the object word and its attributes. For an example, the mother scolded the naughty child. In this sentence, the mother is the subject. Scolded, verb. The naughty child, object. Now, we are taking the object, the naughty child. We can divide it into two parts. Here, child is the object word. The and naughty are the attributes. Very often, we require two objects with a transitive verb. They are direct object and indirect object. Usually, the answer to the question, what is the direct object? Often, the indirect object comes before the direct object. Usually, the answer to the question, what is the direct object? The answer to the question, whom is the indirect object? Let us see the example. Payal gave Rupa a book. Here, we have two objects of the verb gave. When we ask the question, Payal gave what? We get the answer, a book, which is called a direct object of the verb. Now, if we ask whom the book was given to, we get the answer Ruba. The word rupa is the indirect object of the verb gave. Underline all the important points in your textbook and learn it.